Hey, thank you so very much. I just want to tell you that I'm one of nine children. I was born in Kessel Air Force Base in the town of Atwater, so I feel like I'm a cousin. You know, like a cousin. But it's great to be with you, and I just want to say thank you for coming out tonight. I know that some of you, this is your class time, but you still made it. So round of applause for the church for coming out. Thank you. I come to you from the Franciscan School of Theology, formerly in Berkeley, California, now in Oceanside, Mission San Luis Rey at the University of San Diego. And my work has been in multicultural ministry, but I've been a youth minister and a music minister and a catechist and a longtime Catholic lay evangelizer for most of my life. So tonight we're going to talk a little bit and sing a lot about the Holy Spirit, and that the Holy Spirit is the one who brings us life. Jesus sends us the Spirit. There are lots of spirits out there, the spirit of fear, spirit of confusion, spirit of overwhelm and anxiety. And we're talking about tonight, we're talking about the Holy Spirit. And this is really the heart of the church. This is really the birthday of the church is Pentecost. So I'm going to encourage you to give this moment a chance. I know that you've probably spent a day in class or at work, and I'm just going to say that God has something remarkable for each and every one of us. So do what you can to simply turn over and to surrender any distractions that you might have, any concerns, and just be here in this moment and trust the Spirit. When someone asks you this question, who's the church? Together you say, we are. Who's the church? When somebody asks you, where's the church? You say, right here. Where's the church? When somebody adds a three-letter conjunction, you say, everywhere. And? So who is the church? Where's the church? And? How do we live our Catholic faith? And all are welcome because? And we want to always leave room for the Holy Spirit to surprise us. Come now, come now, many. just clap one time, two times. Only if Simon says, the Spirit gives us the mindfulness and the awareness to be present. The Spirit gives us the mindfulness and the awareness to be present. There's a time to work and a time to toil, a time to laugh and a time to grieve. There's a time to pray, there's a time to play, and there's a time to listen to the still small voice of the Spirit. That's how we grow in faith. That's how joy grows through grief and confusion. When we're mindful that we live in the loving care of the Holy One, then come what may, the Spirit leads us through, because we are the church. Who's the church? Yes, and it is a beautiful architecture, but this is the church. The church are who we are. We are a people of God. When we talk about the church, we're talking about flesh and blood and family. Where's the church? Wherever two or three gather in prayer, in sacrifice, in joy, and in service, there you will find the church. And the church is literally everywhere. Round of applause for the church. Amen. The Holy Spirit makes us church. In that first Pentecost, the birthday of the Catholic Church, and for the confirmation, the people who are preparing for confirmation, stand up if you will. If you're preparing for confirmation, please stand just for a second. Stand where you are. Stand. Yes. Be bold and stand. Round of applause for you guys. You are the heart of the church. You are the heart of the church. Have a seat. We appreciate you. I know it's tough to be where you are in your life, and you will learn, like many of us who are much older, learn that every season of life has its own unique challenges. There is no easy season in life, but there is a Holy Spirit that leads us through every circumstance of life. Come, Holy Spirit. Santo Espíritu, we are all called to. Like Our Lady of Guadalupe, we say yes to. Like Saint Joseph, we say yes to. Like Saint Anthony of Padua, we say yes to. The Holy Spirit forms us, guides us, inspires us to say yes to. So in that spirit, I would like 10 of you. 10 of you. That's simply saying 5 of you bring a friend. Or 2 of you bring 5 friends. But we need 10 of you. So come, Holy Spirit. Send 10 people to come up here now. So just go ahead. Don't wait. Don't think about it. Yes. Round of applause for the Holy Spirit. 8 more. 8 more. Holy Spirit, yes! 7 more! Yes! Woo! 4 more! Oh my gosh! Yes, yes, come on! Excellent! Oh my gosh! Wow, that's fantastic! Line up side by side, you guys! Oh my gosh! Beautiful, side by side! Excellent! All right, you guys, give these disciples a round of applause as they line up. Beautiful. Now, hear me out. Hear me out, church. This is very important. Who's the church? Where's the church? And? Now, these young people, there's more than 10, because we ask for a number, and the Holy Spirit always says, more. I'm going to send you more than you ask for. So here's the deal, you guys. The Spirit accomplished this. The Spirit in you, already in you and in us, sent these young people. Round of applause for these young people who said yes, yes. All right, so hands up, everybody, hands up. Repeat after me, yes. Lord. Lord. Yes. Lord. Yes, yes. Lord. Amen. Now look back, look at me, young people, look, if you don't know how to do it, this is the teaching. Hands up, ready, and yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Show me yes, yes, Lord. Perfect. Show me yes, Lord. Show me yes, yes, Lord. Show me yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Show me oh. Show me moose. Show me Pikachu. All right, here we go. Who's the church? Oh my gosh. You guys, you know what would be so, this would be crazy. Do you guys want to be crazy for a second? Okay, all right, we're already in here. So go back out. Bring one more person with you. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Bring someone back with you. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. Some of you are bringing adults. Oh my gosh. Oh, you are good. Evangelization. 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 That's what's happening right now. 1, 2, 3, and yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, go! Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord.
Sing it strong. Yes, Lord, 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 yes, Lord
beautiful. Now listen, I was singing this song and I had a group of people. They're like, Señor Jesse, we are from Mexico, Colombia, El Salvador, Honduras, Guatemala. We can sing this song in Español. And I was like, what? Excuse me? We can sing this song in Español. And I was like, no way. And they were like, sí. Sí, señor, sí, sí, señor. Sí, señor, sí, sí, señor. Sí, señor, sí, sí, señor. Amén. Otra vez, sí, señor, sí, señor, sí, señor, sí, sí, señor, sí, señor, sí, sí, señor, amén. All right. Oh my gosh, people from Germany, Jesse, they're from Germany. When we can sing this song in German, I was like, no way. And they said, yeah. Yeah, my hair, yeah, my hair, yeah, my hair. Sing it. Yeah, my hair, yeah, my hair, yeah, my hair. Amen. Vietnamese, Vietnamese. Phang Chua, Phang Chua, Phang Phang Chua. Phang Chua, Phang Chua, Phang Phang Chua. Phang Chua, Phang Chua, Phang Phang Chua. Amen. Filipino. Opa, opa, paninugong. Sing it. Opa, opa, paninugong. Opa, opa, paninugong. Amen. Polish. Polish. Tapanie, tapanie, tapanie. Tapanie, tapanie, tapanie. Tapanie, tapanie, tapanie. Hawaiian, get ready. Hawaiian. Ayakua, 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 Ayakua. Amen. Excellent. In Arabic. Allah, 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 Allah. All right, now, absolute silence. Absolute silence, just our hands. Absolute silence. Ready? Yes. Round of applause for these great disciples. Good job, you guys. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes. Go out into the world, yes, yes, Lord, amen. Si, Señor, si, Señor, si, si, Señor, si, Señor, si, si, Señor, si, Señor, si, si, Señor, amen. Round of applause for the church. Oh, good job, guys. Good, good job. Who's the church? Where is the church? Amen. And everywhere. Turn to someone right now and say, I am so glad that you are here. I am so glad that you are here. Amen. Church, in this we are many, yet we are one. Pull us together, Lord. Come, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Sing it together. In fact, don't just sing it, pray it. Here we go. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come down. Come down. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come now. Okay, hold on one second. Just gather ourselves. It doesn't take much to be distracted, and it's all good. We're grateful to be here, Lord. Keep our eyes on you, keep our ears on you, Holy One. There is so much suffering in the world today, in our own families, in our neighborhoods, in our cities, in our world. But we know that we are not alone. We are not abandoned. For you promise that you will send the Holy Spirit, the Advocate, the Paraclete, the one who accompanies, and you keep your promises. And so in this, we lift our hearts and our voices in prayer as we proclaim, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come now. Come now. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, we sacrifice and share our gifts, not because we just want to. We choose to, because it's what defines us as a people of faith. It's what defines us. But at the beginning, when I was 8, and I was playing my mom's guitar, and I saw a clip of the Beatles. I saw that clip on this show called The Ed Sullivan Show. I screamed out this blood-curdling scream, "Mama!" And she came out of the kitchen. She's like, "What's going on? Are you hurt? What's the matter? What's the matter?" And I said, "I want to be a beetle." It's like, "You want to be an insect?" "No, I want to be a beetle." "Oh, you want to be a musician?" "Yes, I want to rock like a beetle." And she's let me play her guitar. And my brother Frank and my brother Joe, the three of us taught each other how to play guitar, because there was 9 of us. There would be no music lessons. So we blame it on the Holy Spirit, one chord at a time. And there was this religious brother who heard about these three little brown brothers who were trying to learn guitar. And we knew him at Mass at the base chapel, the Air Force Chapel. And he'd show us a new chord or another chord. And before you knew it, 5th grade, 6th grade, 7th grade, 8th grade, we were getting really good, really good. We're practicing all the Beatles songs. "Yesterday, all my donuts went so far away." And we learned all songs. Singing in the dead of night, when your broken wings have learned to fly all your life, you were always waiting for that boat to rise. "Mama, I'm a beetle." We're playing really, we're practicing so good. Mom comes into the room and she's crying, and she says, "Boys, I need to talk with you." And I was the youngest of those three brothers. And I just, my heart was like breaking for my mama. I was like, "What's the matter, Mama? Why are you crying? Why are you sad?" And she says, "No, these are tears of joy. These are tears of joy. I just got off the phone, and your hopes and dreams of becoming a beetle, your hopes and dreams of being great musicians are coming true. The Lord has answered your prayer." And I blurted out, "Oh my gosh, Mama, did the Beatles call?" My brother Frank, the oldest, was like, "You're an idiot." My mom says, "It's better than that. Oh my gosh, Mama, do the Beatles want us to open for them in concert?" My brother Joe, who's 10 months older than me, said, "You're a stupid idiot. Not to worry. We're taking you to the river to go fishing. We're going to use you for bait." "Mama, Joey's going to throw me in the river." "Don't worry about that. This is better than opening for the Beatles." And my last question, "Oh my gosh, Mama, do the Beatles want us to become the Beatles?" My dad, all the way from the garage, "That kid's an idiot." "Jesse, this is better than being a beetle." And I responded, "Get back, demon woman. What could be better than being a beetle?" And she said, "That's what I'm trying to tell you. Father Haley and Father Michael said you boys can play your guitars at Mass." I started crying too. "Don't you want to play at Mass, Jesse?" "No, I want to be a beetle." And then she went to Frank and said, "Frank, will you play at Mass? Will you let the Holy Spirit direct you?" Will you repeat after me, everyone? Show up.
Show up.
Step up.
Step up.
Step out.
Step
out. Plug in.
Participate.
Celebrate.
Share the gift.
Live the faith.
Share the faith.
My brother Frank, he was like, behold the holy mother of this family. I love you, my mother. I love the Lord. I want to be close to you and close to the Lord forever. I will play at Mass.
I was like, what?
Dear Lord, my brother Frank wants to be close to you. You may take him now.
She went to my brother Joe and says, Joe, Frank's going to play Mass. Joey's not. Will you share your gift? Will you repeat after me? Show up.
Step up.
Step out.
Plug in.
Participate.
Celebrate.
Share the gift.
Live the faith. My brother Joe says, behold, O Holy Mother of this family. I love you, my mother. I love our Blessed Mother. I love our Holy Mother Church. I will play at Mass.
What?
Hail Mary, full of grace, send Joey into outer space.
She comes to me and says, Frank's playing, Joey's playing, was you playing at Mass? I said, I don't want to. I have my own dream.
And my mom says, well, I'm not going to force you. And I was like, what? And she walks away. And I'm like, 5 steps, she turns and says, don't forget who does the cooking. At that moment, I felt the Holy Spirit touch me.
No, seriously, the Holy Spirit touched my heart, which surprisingly was located near my stomach.
I started playing at Mass. That's how I became a guitar player and a singer. My brothers to this day still play at Mass. They play at nursing homes just like myself. They play at jails. They play everywhere that we get invited. The Holy Spirit does that, church. The Spirit does that. We're plugged into community and we live and we grow and we're able to defend against dark forces and harm, not with perfection, but with great gratitude. The Holy Spirit calls us to community. We are the church. Round of applause for community.
It's what being a church is all about. We all have gifts.
That way, you go that way. You share that gift, you have this gift. Everybody, let's go this way. Let's do it all together now. All together. It's brilliant and wise to connect in community. There's something courageous and wise about connecting with. We're not the same, we're different stories, different cultures, we're a variety. God loves variety. So we celebrate God as we celebrate. For God really loves. And variety brings. Say it again, variety brings. Look at the joy of these faces. Look at that pure joy. That's what happens when we celebrate variety. Then be afraid of, oh what, this kid here? No, he's full of joy too. But let's not forget, we have to be practical too. Listen to what that kid's trying to tell us. Listen now. Holy Spirit, give us the ears to hear. What might he be trying to say? My heart.
heart is full of joy. However, my diaper is full of other stuff.
And somebody has to take that lead. You hear what I'm saying? And in a moment, praise God. Round of applause for the church that serves. We're filled with joy. We express our gratitude. Filled with joy. We express our... frustration, whenever we're bored,
We can simply turn to the Spirit and say, come Holy Spirit. When someone has said something hurtful, when someone has misunderstood us, when we've made a mistake, when we've done something terribly wrong, the first solution is always, come Holy Spirit. Come Holy Spirit. And it helps us, the Spirit reminds us of who we are. And we don't have to get swept away in the fear, swept away in the shame, swept away in any sense of humility or of humiliation. But the Spirit will give us humility and return us to the truth, who's the church. And that's something to celebrate. That is something worth celebrating. Always wear the church. And where is the church?
Right here.
It's where two or three are gathered. In this space right now, in this time. Holy Spirit, you are present here. In our friendships, in the people that we stretch out and make new friendships and new connections. And when you take your gift and you step up and show up and you share your gift, that is the church. That is life-changing. That is world-transforming. And it's a beautiful thing, because that's who the church is. We're not perfect, but we are holy, and we find our way. Sometimes we hit the target, and sometimes we miss it terribly. So she's going to be a letter carrier. She loves to work at jobs that allow her to be active. But when I was writing this song, I said, Jenna, what do you think about this? And this is what I wrote. At the beginning of the song, it sounded like this, you guys. It sounded like this. All are welcome in this place. Behold God's amazing grace. All are welcome. All are welcome. Bring your hopes, bring your dreams. Mercy flows, Christ redeems. All are welcome. All belong. I said, what do you think? What do you think, Jenna? And Jenna goes, Dad, you're Catholic, right?
Yeah.
And I'm Catholic, right, Dad?
Yeah.
Not everybody's Catholic. True. Not everybody's even like into church.
True.
Some folks are Christian.
True.
Dad, you want to do something crazy? You want to get some ice cream? No, 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 Dad. What if you took Behold God's Amazing Grace, change that to Behold Love's Amazing Grace? Then whoever heard this song, they could actually see themselves in this song. So let me think about that. Dad, we're not done. Mercy flows and Christ redeems. Mercy flows and love redeems. Check it out, Dad. Check it out. And I'm singing. All are welcome in this place. Behold love's amazing grace. All are welcome. All are welcome.
Bring your hopes, bring your dreams. Mercy flows and love redeems. All the world come, all below. I said, yeah, that works. That works. And I said, yes. Thanks, Jenna. Great idea. So I sent the music to my publisher, Oregon Catholic Press, and I wrote Jenna Manibusan on the manuscript. They sent a contract to Jenna and myself. Jenna calls and says, Dad, what's wrong with your publisher? They sent me a contract. I know, Jenna, your name is on the song. You're a co-writer with Daddy. What? I'm not a songwriter. I know, it doesn't matter. The Holy Spirit made it happen, honey. It's a much better song because you helped. Well, what does that mean? Honey, if the church loves the song and can use the song, then in 20 years, maybe you'll get $13. And she says, tell me more. She got her first royalty check, which was $7. She was all excited. 3 months later, she got a check for $20. 3 months later, she got a check for $250. She goes, Daddy, do I have to share any of this with you? Not at all. That's cool. That's cool. The last check of the year, $750. She calls me up and says, Dad, can we write more songs? And I told her that we're not pursuing a career, we're not pursuing money, we're pursuing Jesus. But we can do that and we'll see what the Spirit provides. So will you join me and Jenna and proclaim Christ in the world? All are welcome in this place. Behold flowers, amazing grace. All are welcome. All are welcome. Bring your hopes, bring your dreams. Mercy flows and love redeems. All are welcome.
Thank you. of applause for the church. Good job. You're doing great.
Another round of applause for our music ministry.
Holy cow.
How's it going over there, George?
And I had George's mom's tortillas today. I was like, Feliz Navidad. Beautiful.
As a church, we'll make mistakes along the way. We're human. Don't give up. Ask for help, offer help. That's the key. If you have a bad experience in the church, ask for help, offer help. Don't give up. Speak the truth. You're part of this community. You're an essential part of this community. You are the church. Trust God. Trust the Holy Spirit. Don't give it all to another person. It's not fair to them or to you. Trust God. Trust God.
Jalen Warren's going to catch it. Okay, it's called the trust ball. Okay, trust ball. Ready, set, go.
Yeah. Trust God.
Whatever you do, listen to the Holy Father who says, our contagious joy must be our first testimony to the closeness and love of God. Our contagious joy must be our first testimony to the closeness and love of God. Remember the first times that you felt absolutely loved and cherished. And then you found out that life is complicated. You found out that life is fragile. Just remember, cultivate joy. Cultivate joy. That's how we know the closeness of God.
Fly like a bird to the Lord, my soul. I want to soar like a eagle. Though
I'm
Who's the church?
Jesus.
It is. Remember this, Azim. When we leave this place, let's remember who the church is and where is the church. Hold on to that in the deep places. Don't let life take it away from you. Come, Holy Spirit. And
everywhere.
That's the good news. That's the great news. It's the great, great news. If I could get one more group of people up here real quick, be great. We got one. Couple more. Let's get a couple more. Come on. Bring it up. We got one. We got two. We got three. We got four. We got four. Can we get some more? We got one, two, three, four. We have two more over here. Three. All right. There you go. You guys having a good time? I know you guys, give yourself a round of applause so you can hear me. This next song is called Fish With Me, and it's really the call, it's the call of Jesus to the original 12, to the confirmation candidates. Your call is from the community, but primarily it's from the Holy Spirit. We pray with you in support. And to all the sponsors, to all the parents and all the siblings, to the whole community, we gather in support of you. Know that you are, in the toughest of times, you are not alone. You are not alone. So, all right. So, guys, turn around, look at me, and just with your hands. You guys follow me. Ready? Oh.
Oh, boy.
One more time. Oh, my God. I just realized when I laugh, my guitar jiggles. Oh, come and follow me. Oh, leave behind your nets, I call you. Leave behind your nets, I call you. Oh, come and fish with me, and your lives will never be the same again. Lives will never be the same again. Excellent. We need women in the church up here too. Yeah. Round of applause for women in the church. We need, come on, women, grab one over there. We got one. Send women to lead. We need women leading us as well. Women, step up. Don't think about it. Just step forward. Show up. Step up. Step out. We got three. All right. Praise God. Praise God. Powerful women in the church. We got two more over here. Praise God. We got women in the church representing. Yes, praise God. We got two more. There you go. That's how we do it. That's how we do it. Amen. Good for you. Good for you. Here we go. Ready? Repeat after me nice and strong. Oh, come and follow me. Oh, leave behind your nets. I call you. Leave behind your nets. Oh, come and fish with me. Your lives will never be the same again. Lives will never. No, be strong. Who's the church? That's what we're looking for. Oh, come and follow me. Oh, leave behind your nets. I call you. Leave behind your nets. Oh, come and fish with me. Your lives will never be the same again. Lives will never be the same again. Here we go. One, two, three. Get ready, say, oh. Come and follow me. Jesus said, oh. Shout it out, casting out their nets into the sea.
rock and I love taking turn on mine. Jesus told him honor the commandments of love. Sell off all your riches for love.
A tough one, listen.
If you want to follow me, deny your very self. Take up the cross and walk away with me. It might seem a hardship, an impossibility. Nothing is impossible with. And Jesus said,
who's the church?
We
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Amen. Amen. She's 4, maybe 5 years old, Avery. She goes fishing with her dad. She's excited if she catches a fish. It might be a sunfish or a crappie. It might be a bluegill, but that's not the point. And you remember Jesus and the original fishermen, it turned out to not be about fish at all. And Avery and her dad have this moment. It's a Holy Spirit moment. It's a Pentecost moment. Because when something hits Avery's mind, every emotion that is possible, she expresses joy, fear, excitement, nervousness, anxiety, powerlessness, exhilaration, all of it. And she's yelling and she's laughing, and you're not really sure if she's laughing from joy or laughing from fear. And her father is ever present, simply saying, keep running. You got it? You got it. Keep running. Keep running. To the confirmation of the candidates, and to the siblings, and to the sponsors, and to the family, this is our Pentecost story. And watch the Father patiently let the child grow and be empowered by the experience, not by taking anything away. And you'll witness Avery pray the great prayer. The great prayer. Four letters. The great prayer, four letters. No, it's not L-O-V-E. It's H-E-L-P. Watch.
You got it. Keep reeling. You still got it? Don't drop it. Still got it? You keep going. You keep going. No, you keep going. You still got it? You sure? Is it coming?
Yeah. Is it coming?
Oh my God. Oh my gosh, Avery.
just have to put your foot down. This movie came up, and like Jesse James is like, Grandpa Jess, there's a movie about our family.
I'm like, what?
And you're in it. You're in the movie. What are you talking about? What's the name of the movie? Moana. Moana. Come on, Grandpa, take us one at a time. Come on, let's do it again. And I said, what's the name? Moana. And I said, no wanna. Everybody in the truck, one time. And then this one came out. Jesse James. Grandpa, there's another movie about our family. And I said, wait, we're Latinos? We're from Mexico? He goes, well, we're from Guam. We're like Mexicanos, but with a lot of water surrounding us. And I go, oh, let's go. Everybody in the car, let's go. That's one at a time. And I said, what's that in the movie? Coco. And I said, no. The Holy Spirit will lead us. Sometimes we need to say no to certain things. Come, Holy Spirit, give us the wisdom. Give us the wisdom.
We just went through the drive-up window. What did we get, Cooper? Daisy, what did we get in the drive-up window? No, Cooper, let Daisy have some.
Oh,
no, Cooper.
So mean.
Daisy, where'd we go? Did we go to McDonald's?
Selfish dog. I don't like that lady. So mean.
No. Daisy gets hers first.
It's dog racism.
Why does Daisy get hers first? Because Cooper eats her too fast.
Holy Spirit, give us the wisdom. Give us the wisdom to discern what's real. Amen. In closing, who's the church? Where's the church? And how do we live our Catholic faith? And all are welcome because all belong. Thank you so much again. I do have some statements. I do have a small amount of CDs back there. They're $10 a piece. And I know that people don't really spend a lot of money on CDs anymore because our music is available on Pandora, Spotify, YouTube, iTunes, and other streaming technologies. But when I say please buy a CD, this is the reason. That's a lot of kids. That's a lot of movies. That's a lot of college. That's a lot of college. Let's end with this great song of evangelization. And Jesus said, oh, come and follow me. Jesus said, oh, keep your mind in as I call you. Oh, come and wish for me. And your life will never be the same again.
God bless you. Have a great night.